did it, guys. We did it. 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 We did it because of your incredible dedication and devotion, your heart and hard work. We made this happen. Now, as many of you know, Joshua's just 2 years old, and he's just learning lots of new words now. So when we heard the good news that we'd won, I turned to Joshua and I said, "Hey Joshua, we won." And he looked at me and he said, "Success." I thought that he was excited about us winning, but actually he was just holding up a cookie that somebody gave him. So everybody's happy, though. Everybody's happy. We won. We won. Now, what's amazing is, guys, over the course of the last couple weeks, there have been so many people who've come up to me who've said, "Eric, I'm really not sure about you." They said, "But I'm voting for Sheena to be the next first lady, and isn't she gonna be amazing?" I'm blessed with a beautiful, wonderful, supportive family. I'm so glad that Joshua and Jacob are here, even though it's far past their bedtimes. And I want to acknowledge my parents, Rob and Becky. And Sheena's parents, Tim and Janet, who are the most awesome grandparent babysitters you could ever ask for. Guys, Sheena and I thank all of you for your faith, your hard work, your service, your sacrifice, your courage, and the fact that all of you have had our back. Thank you so much. You have had our back. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Now, folks, earlier tonight, I spoke to Chris Koster, and he offered his congratulations to me and to all of you. Yes. And to those of you who are on this team, who've been on this mission for a while, let us always remember that the greatest virtue of the victor is magnanimity. Yeah. Magnanimity. Let us be humble, let us be welcoming, and let's let everyone who worked for Chris Koster know that we aim to serve them as well. We're gonna serve them as well. Folks, around this state, there were thousands of people who stepped up, who joined this movement, who joined a grassroots movement the likes of which hasn't been seen in Missouri in a generation. And people, we had law enforcement officers who brought out their friends and their family. I mean, they made thousands of phone calls for us. We had high school students who were up before the sun rose hanging up campaign signs. And we had so many strong veterans from around this state who stood beside us. And I know that we did something truly special. I know that we did something truly remarkable because somebody just told me that we even had an Army guy who voted for me, so we're bringing everybody together. Look, folks, buddy? Okay, buddy. Guys, this campaign reminded all of us. It reminded all of us that great teams are forged in the fire of great struggle. Great struggle. And all of us on this campaign, we knew how much it was at stake. We knew how many people were counting on us to win this election. That mission gave us clarity and courage. That sense of shared purpose gave us strength. And look, like me, most of you have never been involved in politics before. But you joined us, you carried our message, you believed in what we could do together, and tonight we made our voices heard. And look, folks, I know that this wasn't easy. This wasn't easy. But can I ask you all something? Did we have fun? Yes, we did. Yes, we did. We had a fantastic campaign. Folks, tonight begins a new generation of conservative leadership here in Missouri. Tonight, we did more than win an election. We restored power to the people, and we took our state back. There are so many tens of thousands of people around the state who are now counting on us. Children in a foster care system that is failing them. You may never meet them, but they need us. Tonight there are children in the inner cities of St. Louis and Kansas City, in the suburbs of Springfield and Cape Girardeau, and outside the farms of Hannibal, Maryville, and Mountain Grove, who are wondering if the American dream still applies to them, and we must stand up for them. There are law enforcement officers and first responders tonight who are putting their kids to bed and kissing their spouses goodbye. And they must know that we are always going to have their backs. So, folks, here's what we're going to do. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take on the special interests and we're going to clean up Jefferson City. We're going to build a thriving economy here in the state of Missouri, rooted in the core values of hard work and personal responsibility. That's what we're going to do. We're going to work to see that every child in the state of Missouri, whether in homeschool, private school, or public school, that they all have the opportunity to live up to their God-given potential. We're going to stand behind our families, our churches, and our synagogues. We're going to hold the line, and we will not expand Obamacare here in the state of Missouri. We are going to fight for Missouri values. We are going to defend life, and we are going to protect our constitutional rights. And to our soldiers, our sailors, our airmen and Marines, we're going to make Missouri the best state in the country for veterans. Now, guys, our mission in this campaign was to do more than to win an election. Our mission in this campaign was and is to build a stronger and a better Missouri that we can take in a new and a better direction. And that's what we're going to do. That's what we're going to do. What we've really earned tonight is something sacred. What we've really earned tonight is the privilege to serve. And as your governor, I intend to serve as a servant leader who serves all of you. Now, we have to take all of this energy, all of this compassion, all of this courage, and use it to build a Missouri that we are proud to pass on to our kids and our grandkids. Sheena and I, we are honored, we are humbled, and we are inspired to have done this with you as our team. Guys, almost 3,000 years ago, the poet Homer wrote the story of an ancient warrior named Odysseus. When his war was over, Odysseus and his crew faced a difficult journey home. Thinking of the obstacles and all of the uncertainty ahead, they said this, "We will endure it. Keeping a stubborn spirit inside us, we have done much hard work on the waves and in the fighting. Now, let this adventure begin." Yeah!